Hi, my name is Rebecca, and in today's lesson, we're going to talk about how to say yes and no in English. Now, that seems fairly obvious, I'm sure. You're probably wondering, what is she talking about? When you want to say yes, you say yes. When you want to say no, you say no, right? Well, yes and no, because usually in English, we don't actually just say the word yes. Sometimes we say yes, followed by something else, and sometimes we just say another word or expression instead of that. So let's look at some of the options that you have. Because in English, if you only say yes, or if you only say no, it sounds a little bit short, it sounds a little bit rude, or it sounds like you don't really want to talk to the other person, or as if the other person has just disturbed you. So you want to really say something a little bit more, even if it is to a stranger. So let's look at some options, okay? We're going to look at some formal responses, and then we're going to look at some informal responses, all right? So if somebody asks you, could I sit here? Or is this seat free? You could say, of course, or yes, of course. You could say, by all means. Could I sit here? By all means. By all means means yes, of course. Of course you can. You could say, go right ahead. This is a little bit more informal. Go right ahead. Could I sit here? Absolutely. Okay. Could I sit here? Certainly. All right. You see how I've said yes without actually saying the word yes? All right. Of course, I can say yes before each of these. Yes, of course, yes, by all means, yes, absolutely, yes, certainly, okay, yes, go right ahead. You can do that too, or you can just use these by themselves. That's in a slightly more formal situation. With friends, you might want to use something a little more informal, okay? Your friend says, do you want to go grab a bite to eat? Do you want to go grab a bite to eat means, would you like to go and eat something? Would you like to go out to eat something? So you could say, yeah, sure, or just sure. You could say, no problem. That's actually going to be more in a situation, for example, could I borrow your pen? Could I borrow your book? No problem. Like, go right ahead, no problem, okay? Another one, you bet. Are you coming to the party on Saturday? You bet. It's another way of saying yes, of course. All right? But again, a little more informal. Let's look at some ways in which we can say no. All right? So let's say you're at the library. This actually happened to me yesterday. I was at the library, and a student who was sitting in front of me with her laptop said she wanted to go to the washroom, and could I please watch her laptop while she was away? And I didn't want to do that because I didn't want to take responsibility for something a little bit expensive. So I said to her, I'm afraid not. She asked me, could you please watch my things while I go to the washroom? And I said, I'm afraid not. And because we don't want to seem unfriendly or unhelpful, sometimes we explain, I'm afraid not. Actually, I'm leaving in a few minutes. And that way, the person doesn't feel hurt. We're not trying to be mean. I wasn't trying to be mean. I was actually leaving in a few minutes. So I said to her, I'm afraid not. I'm going to be leaving in a few minutes. Okay? Or no, I'm sorry. Again, not just no by itself, but no, I'm sorry. I'm going to be leaving in a few minutes. Or not really, because I'm going to be leaving in a few minutes. Or even without the word no, you could say, actually, I'm leaving in a few minutes. And that's another way of saying, in effect, no, I can't. All right? If you're with your friends and buddies and you're joking around, you could always say, hey, are you going to see your girlfriend again? No way. Okay? Let's say you broke up with her, right? So you want to say, no way. Or nope, that's another way, nope. That's another way of saying no. Or sometimes we just make a kind of a sound that says nah, nah. All right, that's really informal. That's with your good buddies and your good friends, okay? So of course, depending on the situation, you're going to say something more formal or less formal. All right? So I'm going to come back in a minute and tell you some more ways in which you can say yes or no. I'll be right back. Okay, so let's continue a little bit with the second part of this lesson of how to say yes and no. So again, the main point is that you avoid saying only yes or only no, all right? So usually we add a little something. For example, you could say, if somebody asks you, is it 4 o'clock? Instead of just saying yes, you could say, yes, it is. All right, it's the first one. If somebody asks you, are you hungry? Instead of just saying yes, you can say, yes, I am. If somebody asks you, were you at the concert last night? Instead of just saying yes, you could say, yes, I was. If someone asks you, do you like strawberry ice cream? Instead of saying yes, you could say, yes, I do. If someone asks you, did you go to the party last night? You could say, yes, I did. Okay? So again, yes, it is. Yes, I am. Yes, I was. Yes, I do. Yes, I did. Okay? It can flow like that. The same is true for the word no. Instead of just saying the word no, you need to add a little tag to it. Is it 4 o'clock? No, it isn't. It's 5 o'clock. Are you going to the party tonight? No, I'm not. Were you at the party last night? No, I wasn't. Do you like chocolate ice cream? No, I don't. Did you mail the letter? No, I didn't. Okay? So again, this is another technique you can use to say yes or no. If you'd like to do a little more practice in this, please visit our website at www.ingvid.com, and we have there after each lesson a free quiz which you could do to see if you have understood the principle that we're trying to teach you. Okay? Thanks very much. See you again. Bye for now.